Lotta Zeit. I'm from Germany and I live in London since 5 years. I study costume design at London College of Fashion. And my drag king stage name is Otto Autobahn. And yeah, this is the first time I've entered a drag king or any sort of drag stage, and I'm happy to be here. Nice. It was quite surprising. I got quite a good response. And obviously I had all my friends there, but people were telling me that they really enjoyed it, and yeah, it was really rewarding. I do performance design at uni.
Yeah.
So I'm in my course, we don't learn how to perform ourselves, but we learn how to design for performance. So
yeah,
I learn how to make costumes for theatre or film.
So that's why you have a great outfit.
I can know how to make outfits,
yeah,
but we don't learn how to perform. This is why I ended up here, because I always felt like I'd quite like to perform something or be on stage in front of people, but I can't sing or play an instrument, but I can dance and I like being silly, so exactly. That's where I ended up. Well, I don't think my sexuality plays any role in this, to be honest.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't like solely identify as gay at all.
Mm-hmm.
I like all people, and I don't think it actually matters too much. I can see how it maybe matters to the community, but I just think it should be less and less of even a question or an issue to this sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Same as gender.
Mm-hmm.
Should be less of something that has to be identified. It's just fun. If I hadn't chosen to be a costume designer, to be honest, it's still my dream to be a famous costume designer. It hasn't happened yet. So this is what I'm pursuing. I do think, obviously, it would be amazing to be a performer and stuff, but this is still my dream. Like, the peak of what I want to create is make performance art, make like art in spaces with light and sound, and make theatre, make like political theatre.
Yeah.
But I haven't gotten there yet, so it's really still my dream, like absolute top dream, so I'm gonna go for it. Like, being in London is very privileged that everybody around me feels pretty similar to the way that I think about gender and sexuality, and about how men and women or any other gender lives out their sexuality. But the way that it's represented makes me quite frustrated a lot of times. Like, I'm from Germany, and like Germany is really kind of full of that as well. Then even in the town that I'm from, in Nuremberg, where there's like 500,000 people, even there, I feel like I'm like working against some sort of brick wall where people don't understand why I would dye my hair black, or why I would shave it, or why I would do any sort of thing for fashion or performance, because I don't understand the concept that gender might be fluid.
Yeah.
And like I do think that there's a time and space for women to just embrace themselves, to like grow their pit and do what they want, and not feel like that actually through doing things like this you get so much more gratification than through any sort of social standing or like beauty standard.
Yeah.
And I feel like that is the main the outcome that you get out of things like this. Like, you are a woman if you choose to, you're a man if you choose to, and you're something in between if you choose to, but you don't have to fit into it because of the way you look. Like, that's basically what this is all about.
Okay. Cool, thank you.